Hello, game devs. Today we're going to be talking about materials and how they're useful, especially looking at Valorant. And there are other games out there that do a really good job of using textures and materials to their advantage by and also having a really simple environment. So you can really get a lot out of just 2D images. If you are someone who actually doesn't really care for 3D, this might also be really interesting to you as well. So materials are really useful. They allow us to apply images and also create lighting effects. So, you know, whether or not it is transparent or very glossy, that kind of thing, the materials will take care of that. So what we're going to do here today, we're going to go into just like an open range, and we're going to just take a look at how they create a set of textures, what they're doing here. Loading up. Pick Sage, because that is my main. So, one of the things to note here is that Valorant has really low polygonal density. There's not a lot of high mesh polys. The meshes that are high poly are like the characters, which are the most important thing. But if you like take a look at this column here, this column is nothing more than a square with a bevel on it, and that's something that you can do straight in Pro Builder. And a lot of this is, potentially done as a prototype, at least in Pro Builder. The texture on the brick is what, the texture on the pillar is what gives it kind of its depth and interest. So there's some very light spackling and that kind of thing going on here. It's, something that's really not very detailed, but also gets the job done wonderfully. So one of the things that you'll know, you'll notice also, we've got the floor here. We've got only a couple sets of materials. So we've got this floor material. We've got, some concrete pillar, which will repeat over and over again. And then we've got these, almost impressionistic wood panels, of which there are a couple, but then we repeat them over and over again. So, you can see the same streak in this panel, this plank, as this streak here. So these are identical panels, but you don't necessarily notice that, especially when you're just running around. It's not, your main shtick. So one of the nice things about materials is also that you can blend them, especially in more advanced tools that Unity has to offer. And by blending, we can see this in two ways in this area. One is between this repeating tileable texture and this grass here. So when you get to your terrain tool, you'll actually be able to see the same kind of effect that you can do this with terrain to kind of paint paths and that kind of stuff. In this case, they're trying to indicate that this is kind of overgrown, and there's obviously some nature over there, so it's different. It's showing that there is kind of an interplay between the things that are being constructed in the world and the background area. We can also see this up in the brick texture here. We've got this, orange-ish light tan paint texture. And then that is on top of, and you can, see like right here, it's just on a kind of an overlay color on top of this brick. And what they do is they just kind of erase away some of it. This is probably using Substance Designer or something similar. They're using maybe height maps or something to figure out exactly what parts should be worn away first and what parts should be worn away second. You'll also notice that these bricks then go, into this more large brick. We see the same technique here. There's kind of some wear and... We can see this kind of same technique here. There's kind of some wear and tear down here near the pipe. But this is all just, you know, a repeating texture of bricks. And there, you know, it's a little fantastical. Obviously, there's some pieces missing. But one of the things you'll notice also is that the designers or the artists who are creating this area, they're creating natural wear. And they're creating it where, you know, it might happen. So there's this big chunk that got took out of this wall, and then there's some natural wear from the paint here as if there was some erosion going on. So obviously, whatever happened a long time ago, at least to this crack, but probably to the rest of it, since this also has the same kind of effect. So with texture, you can tell story. And this is, again, a repeatable texture that just goes on and on and on forever, which is really great. So the other thing that you want to do when you're using materials is use transparency. We've got transparency over here, and we've got these kind of very flat. Once we look at them, this is just a little vine, but it is just a flat texture that is kind of billboarded to, or not billboarded, but to the facing this direction. And we use these transparent objects to kind of indicate more volume. Foliage is one of the more pain in the butt kind of things to do in order to make something look good. And as you can see, there's a bunch of foliage on these trees and that kind of thing. If I was to decrease, the foliage is just kind of spawning out of this. If I was actually to decrease my visual rendering, if, for instance, when I'm running this on my 2015, this is actually just a cone. There are no leaves on it at all. It's just a one texture that repeats over and over again, wrapping up it. So it's actually kind of nice to see the differences here. I will try to put a side-by-side comparison right here. All right, so one other thing that we do in order to create variation within a space is we use decals. We can see this here within this graffiti texture. This is just a decal, or sometimes it's called an overlay, that we might put this up somewhere to kind of increase the amount of variety in the area and customize it even further. You can see that this stamp, this grenade stamp, is used several times, 1, 2, 3. And then, you know, there's this, and then this one over here. It looks like it's being repeated, you know, exactly. So, we're just reusing a set of graffiti textures that an artist might have created or an artist might have put here to make this area look more interesting. All right. So one of the nice things about this space also is that it is well designed in the way that it is using only a few sets of materials. Like if we think about it, we've got like this bench texture here, which is wood. There's probably a bench texture. We've got this concrete, which is the same concrete that is over here or over here on this wall. We've got a couple box textures, crate textures, that kind of thing. We've got this one door texture, maybe 40, 50 at tops, like once we go through the whole level, and they're using them really exceedingly well in order to kind of create a space. So you'll notice in here, it's a little bit more sterile. Once we come out here, we get a lot of green kind of fading in and out within the same steps and flagstones. And then once we start moving in here, we see a cleaner view again, as if we're leaving behind the green, even though it's kind of seeping in a little bit up on the top here on the roof where there's holes. This area over here is just very wooden. Plank boards are just repeated textures over and over again, and we see the same doors from the other side. And this also gives a nice vista. One nice thing about any game and any good level design is that you go from interior and this is looking at this, we started in here, very claustrophobic, very small area, and then we immediately are allowed to go outside to this kind of wonderful floating island vista. That's probably also a texture or a material, that thing way out in the distance. It's probably not a real geometry, or if it is, it's very low poly. So that's also how we can use materials. The skybox, also a material, very impressionistic, and there's a animated texture here that allows the scene to look really cool and interesting, and kind of hint at what's going on. You can always see these steeples and stuff kind of being flung from any point in the outside. But we go from inside to outside. We go back inside here, and then, you know, I kind of consider this an outside area. So another way of, using your texture set very wisely is if we take a look at these walls. This is brick and this kind of, tannish color. If we go in here, look at this. We've got that same texture, but it's in more of a white. So one way we do this trick, we use this albedo texture, and we just kind of tint it the color that we want. So we can get a lot more out of things that are, just generically white, because then we can tint it different colors very quickly and kind of swap stuff out. This, again, will give you a lot more distance in the amount of materials, especially if this is a, 1024 by 1024 texture with a normal map. That could be 2 or 4 megs. It can be a lot. So another aspect of good texturing is using textures to break up a scene. And also kind of to show where there might be normal wear and tear. So I think it makes sense that this is a shooting gallery here, skills test, start practice. It makes sense that the floor is all torn up out there and maybe a little less on the left. But this tells a story of some explosions going on down in here. The materials also tell a different story than the rest of the area. This has been all brick and kind of stucco, or whatever we want to call this, painted over brick. We have very nice older kind of wood area dock. But then we come in here into this training room, and it's obviously retrofitted. We've got this texture of metal for the girders and everything going on. We've also got this like electrical panel that kind of got slapped on to the wall, which is very, very low poly. It's, a very flat looking thing with a box and a couple of extra boxes attached to it. But we can definitely tell that this area, this thing was inserted afterwards. The texture of the wall here is, kind of metal. And then we've got, this kind of concrete brick, obviously done later than the brick bricks, the red bricks. We can see the concrete blocks, that kind of retrofit into this area. So we're telling a story, and we're using one or two types of textures in each area to kind of make a variety in the scene, and also kind of create a balance. So it's not all textures all the time. Sometimes you're going to want to use one more heavily than others if you're going to want to make an interesting scene. You're going to want to use create wear and tear in normal places where that might be. So like when we were looking at over here, when we're looking at over here, make normal wear and tear decisions. This might often be a path for, where people are walking, if it's through grass or whatever. And then also use decals, either use decals like this over here, the big ones, and lay them out, or also, also we use decals day to day when we shoot the wall. Let me get closer here. We use decals when we shoot the wall. These disappear eventually, but this is also a nice way to kind of add battle damage. That's usually how we do it. And the other thing I'd want you to do is to line up your brick textures. So we kind of see that the developers are kind of hiding the seams here. you know, which is okay because this brick kind of is horizontal, and then this brick is, you know, these are perpendicular to each other. But, you know, when I, what I'd like you to do is make sure that your seams line up. Here we can see this texture doesn't line up all the way for everything. This can be hard, and you know they made a judgment call to not do the not do it very much, and instead kind of stick a plank there, and made it look kind of nicer. And then this is obviously two different areas. So I think you know this is also maybe hinting that these archways got built later, possibly. You know maybe this archway thing all got built after these buildings got built. In between, and you know, they were different brickwork or something. But it does tell a story. And you want to make sure that your bricks generally wrap around, especially like over here. We see that this did a good job. We've got bricks that go around, and we don't have, for the most part, we don't have a horrible crease. It looks like the bricks are supposed to kind of be there, and then maybe. Maybe, you know, this is a really thin brick compared to this one, but, you know, we can give some people some credit for most of this because it's very small details, especially when you're playing a game. You're not going to really notice this a lot, but you can also use textures and repeat them as detail items. So if you take a look at where it is, here it is. So this is a star window texture, but this window also has the same star texture here. This one also has the same star texture. So we use repeating textures, and then we use objects to kind of break up the scene. We just kind of reuse things all as much as we can. And you know, that's all just to provide additional variety. Here's kind of a nice wear path. You know, the walk is here. For the most part, it looks like it's creeping here, but there's some wear back and forth. And again, just wood, and then the stucco, and this now even whiter brick kind of area. I have no idea how to do that. Oh. Anyway. So yeah, that's about it. This is Valorant. They did a really great job with their materials, using very few of them to repeat over and over again. Here's a planter or something. It's just the same texture repeated. And if you notice, there's not even like much of a normal map or anything on this. Like there's a little bit here, but it's just really an impression of you know, what a column might be. And that also allows them to decrease their file size and makes the game run faster and package smaller, which is really a great idea. So that's all I wanted to go over today. Valorant is a really great example of good texture and material use, and I hope you use it in your level development. I will see you in class.